Welcome back to my channel. So this video is basically something new which is not there, which is not there anywhere. So basically what's the thing, it goes like this. Yeah, good. So for the total population around the world, nearly 18 to 20% of the people are differently abled people. So basically the tech chain companies like Facebook or Instagram, Google, Microsoft has done numerous of researches and they have launched numerous of products for basically for those differently abled persons. Why? Because nearly 18 to 15% of those people doesn't own a laptop or a smartphone or a tablet. So in an underdeveloped countries. So in this video basically we are going to see about the tech chain companies and the recent updates on differently abled persons. So the first tech chain company which I would like to talk here is about Facebook, and the company which Facebook brought, that is Instagram. So basically what Facebook has done is in both Facebook and Instagram there is a new update named as photo description. I think so many people know about it. So basically what is photo description is, if you are taking some photo, basically for visually impaired persons like who are blind or has some problems in eyes, they can just take the photo and the photo will describe each and everything like an assistant. So it basically says what is there in the photo, like a woman or what is her age, the color or some objects which is present there in the picture itself in Facebook and Instagram. And in addition to that, there is a new update which is there in Instagram and Facebook is about the translate of languages. That is cool. So like nearly Facebook and Instagram has given like 70 plus languages, and for each month to 2 months they are just updating the new languages. So with the help of that, even with your mother tongue, you can know about the other things or the other photos which is related in some other languages. So like basically if you want to know some scripts which is there in Hindi, under some photos you can just click on translate and go on the Facebook and Instagram will automatically translate it and it will come into your known languages like English or which language is familiar to you. So this is one thing which I feel it's good. And the next thing which I would like to say is in Instagram there is a special option named as alternate text. So it is basically where in a sense, like when you're posting a photo on Instagram under the in the page where it asks for sharing Twitter or sharing Facebook, and there will be an option named as advanced settings. So when you press on advanced settings, there will be an option named as alternate text. So basically you can ask what this alternate text plays a major role. So the major role of this alternate text is whenever the people just go to your photo, when they press on alternate text, there comes a user defined lines. In the sense, the guy or a woman who is going to upload the photo can write something about the photo itself. So for the visually impaired persons, when you just go to the photo, they can just hear audio it, like what is there in the photo. In the sense, in this photo there is a woman of like 30 years age and she has a black hair or an object. So something like that which is written by the user will come in as an audio. You can ask how this audio is done. In all smartphones or tablets there is something named as writers. Yeah, so writers, in the sense if something text is there like in Google Assistant, something like that. So with the help of that, it will just make it as an audio so that the people, differently abled people, can get an update or news or do anything which a normal person is doing in its day-to-day life. So the next thing which we are going to see is about the Google. So you know about the Google is the Google, whichever product that the Google has launched has a Google Assistant with it. So in addition to that, in tablets like Chromebook, the Google has launched a Google Assistant named as Chrome Voice, which will do all types of works for you in the place of for a differently abled persons. So it will just open anything for you in the tablet or in the laptop, or else if you want to search something or anything, the Chrome box will come and play a role for you. So in addition to that, the Google has launched an app. So the app name is Lookout app. It is basically available in Play Store and iOS, and it has more than 100 million downloads. So you can ask what this app does. So this app plays gives more privacy to the differently abled persons phones, their datas. In addition to that, it can work as the differently abled persons phone's camera, where you can take photos or record videos, and later on you can just translate as audios to the users. And in addition to that, if there is any photos which a user takes, and then the next minute this Lookout app will just go through the things which is there in the photo, and it will just translate it as an audio. So basically these all features comes in the premium version, which is around like $3 per month. So which I feel basically okay thing, because $3 per month for a different able person is good, because they are going to get all privacy, and in addition to that, their phone's location will be tracked each and every time. So in case if they lose their phone somewhere, with help of this app, you can go through it. Even if the phone is running out of battery, this Lookout app will take care of it. Like, I'm not saying about the battery thing, I'm just saying still the location will be on, so that you can just track the phone if in case any emergency happens. So the next thing which the Google is working is about the Google Live Relay. So it is basically for the different able persons, where they can talk in calls like video calls or normal calls, where they are going to translate audio into text messages and text messages to audio. So this is the main thing which this project is working on, that is Google Live Relay. It is basically in research phase, and there is some small amount of success which Google is getting. So it may be launched after 2 to 3 years in future. So the next thing which the Google is working on is a Project Diva. So it is basically like an upgraded version of Google Assistant, where the differently abled persons can directly contact or communicate with the Google Assistant. So like, you can ask, like, Google Assistant is basically something where the user says and the Google Assistant works for you. But here, what is the thing, if the user is a deaf guy, if he's unable to talk, then with help of the Diva button, where he can just post images in the phone, and the phone readers, in the sense like screen readers, will read to the Google Assistant, when Google Assistant will just automatically work as a normal interface as a user and a Google Assistant. So this is basically what the Google is working on, which is currently going on, and it may be launched within like 3 to 5 years. So the last but not the least tech company is the Microsoft. So like, you can ask what Microsoft can do a role for these different abled persons. So in this case, the Microsoft is working on a research on bringing something, a assistant named as Windows Narrator, where in case if the differently abled person is opening any Microsoft applications like PowerPoint or Word or Excel or anything, the Windows Narrator will make it as an audio or in a written form, where all the things will be mentioned, all the things in the sense like either letters of bold, or it is in italic, or if the sentence is underlined, or if there is some color for those words, even the spellings, punctuations, like everything, like if the paragraph is ending out and if the next paragraph is starting. So like, this whole bunch of thing which the Microsoft is working on currently, and what's the thing is, the research is going on, and it may be come into action like around like 3 to 5 years. So this is about what Microsoft is doing on. So basically this is what all the tech giants around the world is working or doing researches for differently abled persons. So you can ask why these peoples, like why these companies are just doing the research on those things. So I just want you to make sure that there are many things where we are just separating them. So for those people who think that they are not as a fully potential guys or something like that, just go to Kim's records, just see what differently abled persons are doing around the world. And in addition to that, they have a separate Olympics for them, like physically challenged Olympics where they can prove their talents. So what to say, before ending this video, I just want to make sure that the respect which we are getting around this world, the same respect goes to them as well, because they are also just a human being. So by ending this, this is the end of this video. So hope so you like this video. If you like this, just give it a thumbs up. So make sure that you stick around to this channel. So in the next video, we just look up all the new tech things or new updates. So till then, peace from K Square. Bye.